Good morning, everybody. It is Thursday, October the 2nd, 2014. It's the Blazing Blogger, Dr. Greenbeard here, and this is your Daily Dose. You guys got back in on it yesterday, dropped a few quotes. One of the quotes that I said yesterday was from, you know, OG Mandino, Og Mandino, and it said, "Failure will never overtake me if my determination to succeed is strong enough." And I'm going to go a step further on that today because I'm feeling a little defeated. And it has to do with the Postal Service and whenever you order something online and they ask you for special instructions, you know? Because I'm at home. I work from home. I'm always home. I have surveillance. So it's like I know when someone delivers something and when they don't. So when I receive an email that tells me that yesterday at 1:50 p.m., my package was delivered, and I'm sitting here the whole afternoon, and I didn't see my package, I didn't see the people come to the door, I didn't get a doorbell ring, nothing on the footage that showed anything delivered, I get upset, I get mad, I get angry, I can't help it because I feel like I'm being lied to. And it makes me feel defeated because I lose faith in humanity because I'm like, how am I getting an email that says I've received my package? And it's like, I could easily just let this, because it happens a lot, I could easily just stop using UPS, stop using USPS, but that's not going to help anything, you know? So today I want to share some. I always go to my little book here, and I have this Chinese Proverbs book here. Whenever I get upset or whenever I need guidance on a subject, I always come here. And so I went to defeat, you know, because I was feeling defeated. I'm like, how can humanity deliver my package when I get into deliver? So here's the only other scenario. Maybe the mailman, the USPS, when they got it, put it into my box because it would fit in there. But it was specifically marked, do not put in box, live insects, okay? So if it's marked that way and the person looked at it and put it in the box, then I'm going to have to question, I question intelligence and humanity nonstop. It just, oh, but let's go and read a little bit from this defeated section before I get carried away. Basically it says, defeat teaches us life's most valuable lessons. And that's true. We learn more from pain than we do from pleasure. So whenever something pains us, we tend to think about it more, look at it more, inspect it more, analyze it more, so on and so forth. This proverb right here goes hand in hand from the quote. It says, defeat is never a bitter brew until one agrees to swallow it. Well, I don't agree to me not getting my package, my live insects, my ladybugs. So I followed, you know, Amazon where you report it and then you file a claim. And yet, it could be a 90-day delay and I won't need the ladybugs 90 days from now, blah, 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 blah. But that's what we can control, so that's what we control. The things we can't control, we don't worry about. That's lessons for another day. But the next says, to be unhappy over what one lacks is to waste what one already possesses. So if I'm going to sit here and be upset all day long because I didn't get my ladybugs, well, that's silly because I can still be cool because I have praying mantises. I have other stuff that I could do. There's no need to be attached to the fact that I didn't have ladybugs. Now, it sucks because I kind of had planned they were going to be delivered, but just move on. It's not hard. Next, avoid defeat and you will avoid success. And that just basically says you're never going to be successful if you're afraid to fail at things. Because nobody bats 1,000 for life. That's just the way that it is. If you bat 1,000 for life, I want to meet you. You don't exist. You know, you're only in fiction. Next it says, a tiny leak will eventually sink a mighty ship. Okay. An error the width of a hair can lead one 1,000 miles astray. Trust me, I know all about that from reading compasses in the military. 420 mark, ding. And then the last thing it says here, a drowning person will not be troubled by a little rain. That one's kind of obvious. I'm pretty sure you've got bigger problems to worry about if you're drowning than a little bit of rain. But, you know, I recommend having a book like this. You know, some people pick up the Bible and whatever it is. For me, I like these Chinese proverbs, you know, there's all different subjects in here. The ability, adaptability, admiration, anger, beauty, compromise, conflict. I mean, there's tons of things. Like, I'll just say, knowledge. Common sense goes further than much learning. despise learning and make everyone pay for your ignorance. You know, so I mean, there's good stuff. But the reason you can avoid a lot of stress by just taking a few minutes. Like today, I use this daily dose as almost like a detox to help me get over the fact that I was so upset about seeing the email this morning that told me my package was delivered when I know that it wasn't. You see? But I'm only going to worry about the things I can control, and defeat is never a bitter brew until one decides to swallow it. So I'm not done with you yet, Amazon and bug people. I'm going to get my ladybugs, and we're going to make sure that we do it through the USPS or UPS, whoever we choose to use next time. Okay? But I just wanted to go ahead and share with you a little bit of thoughts about defeatist or defeatist mentality and how I'm already over it. I want to thank you guys for being the audience for that. And remember, it's all about mindset. You're going to get used to this undercurrent theme. Mindset. I think, therefore I am. I think, therefore it happens. It's amazing, and people think it's so cliche and that can't be possible. All I tell people is this. Look at the people that are telling you that by merely thinking things, they're able to make them happen. And then sit back, and when they make them happen, ask yourself this. Didn't they tell you so? Why wouldn't you just listen to them and do the same thing instead of fighting it? All right, everybody. This was Thursday, October the 2nd, 2014. This is your Daily Dose. See you tomorrow. Peace.